waters, the tamasic waters of ignorance, and on the shore of these tamasic waters of ignorance sits the Purusha in his splendor. That is where Purusha is. This is what they understood. That everything, see, that is why this is repeated twice. First is the understanding of the immanent form, which was already said earlier in the Mahapratigna. Pratigna means a thesis statement. Then it was elaborated. After the name and form and the ego was sacrificed on the pole, what happened? They saw Purusha objectively, without their subjective ragadveshas becoming entrapments in their understanding. They saw clearly that everything is a manifestation of this Purusha. And what did they say? Veda aham etam purusham mahantam. I know this, the splendor, the glory of the Purusha. I know. And who is this Purusha? Aditya Varnam. Like even the color of the sun. All light. And where is this Purusha? Just on the other side of my ignorance. I just have to cross the ignorance, that's all. This side all dark, full of ignorance. This Purusha is waiting to be revealed on the other side of my ignorance. And then what? Then the proclamation is there. You know, this Sarvani Rupani Vichitya Namani Kritva Abhivadan Yada Aste. You know, this, when the Dhira means the one who has overcome ignorance, Dhiman, Viveki, or the one who is in the process of knowing, that also you can take. Then Sarvani Rupani Vichitya, this is what you have to do with every form. This Vichara, this Vivechana, this Viveka has to be there, that in every form and name, I can sacrifice the name and form and see the Purusha, just like saying touch wood. Touch Purusha, touch Ishvara. You can practice this. Yeah, for 1 week you practice this, really. Touch Ishvara. Anything you touch, you say touch Ishvara. See Ishvara. Smell Ishvara. Everything is Ishvara. So, this is what I have known now. You know, and this is what every Dhira knows. Sarvani Rupani Vichitya. Having understood all the names and forms and see the Purusha as taking all names and forms. And those include Brahmaji, Dhata, Purastad, Yamuda, Jahara, Chakraha, Indra, it includes. And everything it includes. It includes everything that Indra even saw. So if there is any penchant for the celestials, Brahma, Vishnu, Indra, Agni, Vayu, who are these in relation to the Purusha? They are all manifestations of the Purusha. And this is who knows? Dhira knows. Who is the Dhira? The one that has gone on the other side of ignorance knows. Tamevam vidvan iha bhavati. Iha bhavati vidvan. Amritam iha bhavati. Iha means what? Here means what? Asmin janmani. In this birth. Not janmantari. The promise, this is the problem with many dominant traditions. That the point of life is afterlife. What is the problem? Why should I? If the point of life is afterlife, what is this life for? Is it a detour or something? Why was I wrong? Like sometimes you drive and you see this sign, detour, take the detour. Why should I have this life? No, in Garden of Eden you were very happy. Theek hai. Then you were banished. Why? Because you some fruit of knowledge, some snake and apple and fruit of knowledge, and then you went, you know, you are banished. Now what's the point? Here you are a sinner, and then what? You have to say, I am saved. Okay, uske baad fir kya? Then you will be back in Eden. You will be saved. Then what am I doing here? Nothing. You are just biding time, like some Trishanku. We don't say this. The purpose of birth is to understand the truth of yourself, and it has to be done right here, right now. Give up the dreams of going to Brahmaloka. Because even if you go to Brahmaloka, udhar kya hoga? Brahmaji will teach. Yes. Brahma, oh, but that's nice. Brahmaji ke saath baith ke sunenge. What will he teach? Purusha Sukta. And you say, oh, Detroit mein aisa tha. Even in Detroit I have this, why didn't I study it then? why did I skip the last lecture? I wish I had attended. What's the point? What's the idea? So the whole thing we have to see the truth of it, that ihaiva bhavati, ihaiva taihi jitas sargaha, yesham samya sthitam manaha. This is Bhagavad Gita also, that heaven is gained by the people here itself, those who have equanimity and those who know this knowledge. Without equanimity, this cannot be understood. This has to be pursued. You know, iha, amritam iha bhavati. Sharira patat prak, meaning before the dropping of this body, one is immortal. How? Body means body is not I. I have nama rupa, I have, you know, atavya, I have let go. It is to be let go. Anything that's an object, anything that's objectified, I have let go, let go, let go, let go, let go. And I understand myself as the Purusha. And this Purusha is without a second. This Purusha is me alone. Let anything happen to the body. As long as I can tune it up and get the oil changed, I will do it. That's all. You get it serviced. You know, take it to the mechanic. Sometimes you have to take it to the emergency mechanic. Theek hai. Wo bhi theek hai. Then what? After that, whatever, let it do whatever. It ages. It rages. Let it age. Let it rage. What is important is that the truth of it is Purusha. I identify with the second Purusha, not with the one that is confined, as it were, in the body-mind-sense complex. How can Purusha be confined in the body? Tell me. Can you capture space? Like if I say, what's in this glass? Glass space. If the glass space had a human mind, it would say, I'm trapped in this tumbler.
Yeah.
I want to join space. Then you have to break this glass. Do you have to break this glass for the glass space to become one with space outside? Do you? Some people are still doubting. Please think it over and get back to me. Do you have to break this glass for the space in the glass to become one with the space outside the glass?
No.
No. Abba. These are the happy moments in the life of a Vedanta teacher. You don't have to. Or do I have to go like this? Come on. Join space. Ridiculous. In fact, I'll give you a Zen-like question. This is what the Zen masters have a very easy life. They don't do lectures and all like us. They come and they will say, is the space in the glass or is the glass in space? Confuse the hell out of you. Then you have to sit and think. They leave town. Visit is over. Oh, Purna Madaha, Purna Vida, finished. And then you have to think, what did they say? This is called a koan. This is called a Zen, K-O-A-N, koan. You know, one shishya came. What did the shishya say? You know, shishya had one lamp in one hand, you know. So the teacher asked, what do you have in your left hand? Lamp, sir. Drop it. He dropped the lamp. What do you have in your right hand? Nothing, sir. Drop it. Ab kya karega, you know? This is what a Zen koan is. Another example. If a redwood tree falls in the forest, does it make a sound?
No.
Sound.
No.
Sound is what? Sound is, you know, sound needs an objectifier of the sound. Who is that? You, the conscious being. Yes. All this they will not tell. They will make you do the hard work. Yes, this is the Zen. So I can ask a Zen-like question. Is the glass in space or is the space in glass? You figure it out. Yeah, that is why, you know, we have the Zen ashram is called Zenitentiary. Yes. So anyway, so this is what the whole thing is. How can space be trapped in a glass? How can space that traps everything be itself trapped? How can this space-like, spacious, commodious, without a second, all-pervasive, limitless consciousness, Satchidananda, be trapped in this body? That is itself a joke. That is why this identification is given up through the knowledge. The identification is given up. Don't start feeling scared. Oh, nothing to identify. You are being invited to identify with Purusha, with everything. You are big enough to identify with the whole. This is what is entailed here, and this is what is saying. Tametam vidvam amrita iha bhavati. So the vidvan of this knowledge, the scholar of this knowledge, the knower of this knowledge, ihaiva amrito bhavati, right here and now, untouched by the fear of death, understands the truth of oneself as truly not subject to time, truly immortal. And then what does it say? What's the next line? Na anyah pantha ayanaya vidyate. This Purusha is the only way. Knowing the Purusha is the only way. And if you had other thoughts, you know, that, oh, maybe there are other methods. Maybe I can bhajan my way to the Purusha. Maybe I can kirtan my way to the Purusha. Maybe I can dance my way to the Purusha. Maybe I can become a workaholic. I'm already a workaholic, but I can work my way to Purusha. No. This is a cognitive shift that has to take place. Na anyah pantha, another way, ayanaya, to follow, to as a goal, other than Purusha. Purusha is the goal, the seeker is the sought. Seeker is Purusha, sought is Purusha, seeker being the sought. There is no other way to understand except by being taught about this through the Purusha Sukta and other such texts. The seeker being the sought, there is no other way to know this. You cannot intuit the self. The self is the intuiter. You cannot infer the self. The self is the inferer. You cannot see the self. Self is the seer. You cannot objectify the self. The self is the subject that objectifies everything. Oh, maybe the self is a big zero. Shunya. Even saying that, we feel like laughing. If you say, I am Shunya, what are you saying? Who is saying I am Shunya? The conscious being. Are you existing or not?
Yes.
If you are existing, how can you be Shunya? You can say, I don't know who I am. But if you say, I am Shunya, it's like a child hiding behind the stairs and saying, don't look behind the stairs. I'm not there. It is called self-denial. It's the most rank disservice you can do to yourself. Taittiri Upanishad says, asanne vasabhavati asad brahmeti vedachet asti brahmeti chet veda santamenam tato viduriti. Asat eva sabhavati. Here we have been spending 3 days saying you are sat, you are all existence. Upanishad says you become asat. Oh, that person becomes asat. Who? Chet, agar, yadi, if what? Asat brahma iti veda chet. If the person says, there is no Purusha, there is no self-shining consciousness, there is no Satchidananda, there is no Bhagavan, there is no Brahman, that self, that person itself becomes non-existent. Yes. It's a rank form of self-denial, self-loathe. To say there is no Brahman means there is no self, because the self happens to be Purusha, happens to be Brahman. So if you deny Purusha, you are non-existent. But then the person who says Asti Brahma. Asti Brahma means what? Asti Purushaha. This Purusha is there. Satchidananda is there. Ishvara is there, the one who says. You don't even have to say Asmi Brahma. That comes later. Asti Brahma. Yes, Brahman is there. Santamenam tato viduhu iti. You can count that person in the Vedic senses among the living, among the existent. Also there is a pun. Santa means saint. The one who says asti, asti, asti. That is the word. That person is known as a saint. The one who knows that this Brahman is myself alone. Here also same thing. There's nothing else to know, nothing else to do other than this Purusha. And ihaiva amrito bhavati, there is no other way. Anya pantha na vidyate ayanaya, not is not there. And then what? Little more ghee they put in this yajna. First the immanent form, now the transcendental form is going to be elaborated. So they continued the worship. Tena jaya deva ayajanta. Who were they? Sadhyaha, the people who were wanting to know this. Rishayaschaye. And then again out of this yajna what came? You know? Tani dharmani. This became their primary dharma. Self-knowledge became the primary dharma of these self-shining beings. And then what happened? Teha nakam mahimanaha sachante. They attain. See, this word nakam is nice. Kam is Brahma. Kam Brahma, kam Brahma. Kam means Brahma. Akam means what? Nakam, akam. Means that is non-Brahma. Na akam, na akam, double negation. Very nice, no? That means sukham, yes, not dukham. This is what it is. So nakam is the ultimate, absolute freedom from limitations. It's not an abode. You have to correct that translation. Abode is you. You know? If you think of it as a different abode than you, then it doesn't bode very well for your studies. Yeah. Abode means you. Abode you change to abide. Then it will be alright. I have to abide in this knowledge. And what is this abode in which I have to abide? That this is the ultimate understanding of the truth of me, where all sorrow is dispersed, all anger is gone, all fear is gone, everything is just myself alone. And then what? This is what Purve, you know, earlier also, as mentioned above, this is what the rishis have attained. And then we have a segue to understanding all the way in which the creation appears, the waters, the earth, and then Brahmaji. And then after creating Brahmaji, all the forms came, and then the design of the universe was infallible, it came. All these, the transcendental forms, the immanent form, everything is there. And again, at that, this is whole repeated. You know, Veda Aham, I know this Purusha from both the standpoints. From the standpoint of the whole universe, I know this Purusha. From the standpoint of Satchidananda, that space-like, sun-like, self-shining consciousness that transcends the universe, which is the truth of myself, I know this Purusha. And there is no other way. This is what the Vidwan says. You know, the one, and where is this Purusha? Right on the door of where the ignorance is there. Knocking on the door of my ignorance is this Purusha. I have to open the door of the ignorance and let this Purusha in. And there is no other way other than taking refuge in this Purusha. And then, what is this whole universe? Nothing but Bhagavan. Prajapati, he is the manifestation of this Purusha in action. That is the source. Ajayamanaha, this is the transcendental form. Without taking birth, he has, you know, colonized the entire universe, populated the entire universe. Bahudha, many forms, without really undergoing any change. And who knows him? The people, the knowers of self-knowledge, know this Purusha. And even Brahmaji is jealous of the people who know the Purusha. That is what the whole idea is, you know. And then, Yodevanam Purohitaha, since it's the Yajna, who is the one who is in charge of this knowledge? Purusha. The presiding priest of this Yajna, Jnana Yajna, the teacher of this Jnana Yajna is nothing other than Bhagavan. This Yajna has yielded the Purusha Sukta, which helps me to know Bhagavan. Just like the Veda comes with every creation, Bhagavan himself gives the knowledge of the self. Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam. This is why I salute the whole lineage of Gurus, starting from Bhagavan up to my own teacher. That is what. And if you say, no, no, I'm not into Shiva, Narayanam Padma Bhuvam, we can have another derivation also. So this is the way it is. So this Bhagavan only is the presiding priest of this Jnana Yajna, the teacher, the instructor, etc. And just to make sure, if anybody thought that they had tied up the Purusha, the Devas tied up the Purusha, here it says, Purvo yo devebhyah jatah. Don't think that the Devas tied up the Purusha, that's just a metaphor. He who preceded the Devas. Yeah, that is what it is. Don't think that there is any mix up here. And then what? Namaha, surrender to that brilliance in me, in Bhagavan, which is one and the same. It is a, what is that? This is a Mahavakya. Namo Ruchaya Brahmane. I am that. This is a Mahavakya. I am that Rucha. I am that brilliance. I am that Chit. I am that Sat, which I glorify in the Purusha. I am that only. And when this knowledge, when the Devas gained this knowledge from the grace of the Purusha, from Bhagavan's grace, what did they say? Yastu evam brahmano vidya. Anyone who understands him in this manner, this Purusha, tasya deva asan vashe, we will gladly become the servants and the slaves of the knowers of self-knowledge. This is the promise of the Deva. This is what I was telling before. You start committing to the teachings. When you see that your life becomes easier, that is the Devas conspiring to take care of you. This is what is the promise given here. Tasya Deva Asan Vashe Asan. Meaning that the Devas happily become enslaved because you are following your purpose. You are following the cosmic purpose for which you are put on the earth. You are doing the most sacred of your Swadharma. I told you in the first lecture, the first Swadharma and the only Swadharma, the primary Swadharma is what? What is your primary duty? To know yourself. That is the duty. That is the reason you were given a human birth. And when the Devas see the person wasting the human birth, you know, in the form of going to malls and balls and everything in between. Yeah, once I was lecturing somewhere, you know, a child asked me, how do you spell mall? I said, M-A-U-L, because it mauls you. Going there mauls you of your sanity. That is what. That is what it is. It is M-A-U-L. That is the new spelling of mall. Remember it next time you go there, okay? Yeah, you can think of me then. So, this is what the whole thing is. Everybody is going from mall to ball and the Devas are not happy. Not happy means what? Obstruction. It comes in the form of obstructions. I see that. Always there are blocks. And then the person asks themselves the question, why only when I go to the mall there are so many vignas? You know, it's very clear. Don't go. When there are vignas, don't go. And here is the only place. Here means self-knowledge is the only place where you have to use your free will in self-knowledge and prayer to cross the vignas. Other vignas, let them go. Here you make the commitment and see how the Devas are like dogs. Devas means the celestial forces of the universe that conspire to feed you, keep you clothed, that bless you, find your job, find your bearings. They make life easier because they heave a sigh of relief. Even Chitragupta heaves a sigh of relief because one more account he doesn't have to keep. He can cross off the jiva, abba, thank God. Iska khata band ho jayega. This is very nice. This is what it is. He can close his account, one less thing to count, poor fellow. He's been counting countless jivas. Give him a break. This is what, give him a break at least and pursue this self-knowledge here. Deva Asan Vashe, the Devas themselves promise here, all the celestial self-shining beings, bless you. Bless the person who pursues this knowledge And they say, gladly we will become the servant of the person who pursues this knowledge. And then what? And the person who has this knowledge has two other things, which the Purusha has. Modesty. Yes. Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmane Gavi Hastini Shunishchaiva Swapakecha Panditaha Samadarshinaha. Bhagavad Gita says that Vidya and Vinaya go together. And that's how you become a Samadarshi. You look at everything with equanimity. You don't have this new ego. One ego was sacrificed at the Yupa of the Yajna, Jnana Yajna. Now I have grown a new ego. I am a Vedantin. Everybody should fall at my feet. Everybody should do this. I don't go anywhere. I won't do this. I have lot of nakras because I am a person of self-knowledge. What are you going to do? I have a board. I am a person of self. You put a board around yourself. I am a person of self-knowledge. It is of no use in the Jagat. Write it on your resume. Nobody will guarantee you will not get a job. It is of no use. And this is called enlightenment ahamkara. So that's why this is given at the very end. Three, you know, you have to be just like the Purusha has two wives with the feminine forces of modesty and abundance. All abundance, all resources. Meaning what? Doesn't hold on to the resources. You have to have that humility. One has to have the humility. The more one knows, the more free one becomes. One is one with everything, one with everyone. Look at our Pujya Swamiji. How is he? He doesn't have airs. He doesn't have all kinds of airs. Oh, I'm somebody special and you should approach me like this. You should do. Anybody who comes, they feel like they are the only person in the room. This is how a person of knowledge, this is how to be. We learn from our gurus, we learn from our elders, we learn from, this is the only way to learn. You watch the person in action and you see the person how they are. And this is why Hrishcha Te Lakshmishcha Patnyauhu, another meaning is there in the sense that this Purusha, the Lakshmi, all the wonderful qualities, humility, abundance, etc. belongs to the Purusha alone. As long as you know Lakshmi belongs to Purusha, you are okay. Lakshmi doesn't belong to you. She just comes to have a cup of tea, that's all. Sometimes the visit is very short and sometimes the visit is long and sometimes she rings the bell and she says, oh, I meant to go to the next house, it's a mistake. I didn't mean to come here. But as long, and you know how to keep her, how to keep Lakshmi? You have to know that she belongs to Vishnu and she is just visiting. The moment you trap her, she goes and she leaves the evil twin behind. Who's the twin? Alakshmi. Aridya. Alakshmi, shadow side of Lakshmi. There is no Alakshmi. Alakshmi is in the heart of the ignorant people. That's all it is. It's the scarcity. Poverty mentality, poverty in thinking, this is Alakshmi. By my own Alakshmi, I drive away Lakshmi. Because Lakshmi says, wherever Alakshmi is, I'm not coming. They don't get along, these two siblings. That's what it is. So as long as you know Lakshmi belongs to Purusha, she'll be happy to stay with you. She's a guest. But if you think you can hold her and hold her, she says, I'm leaving. This is what it is. That is the second meaning here. But the first meaning is preferred because you are all in Vedanta. So the first meaning is what? That all resources are belonging to this person who knows I am this Purusha. All resources are belonging to this person alone. And because the person is full of all kinds of resources, knowledge, abundance, Shri, Lakshmi, everything, prosperity, peace of mind, doesn't grow horns and become devilish in arrogance. Doesn't say, there is no one like me, I am a Vedantin, you have to treat me with respect. One who demands respect is not a Vedantin. Respect is not something you can demand. You command it by what you stand for. Commanding and demanding are two different things. If you command it, that means you know, whatever you are doing is inspiring people to respect you out of their own accord, that's different. It's freely given. And when is it freely given? When is respect freely given? When you do not demand it. You should not need it. To have your own understanding of yourself. And the Purusha does not look for approval anywhere. The self-approving, total, compassionate, abundant. Abundance, Lakshmi is mentioned on purpose here. It's not Vishnu and Lakshmi, no. Lakshmi means the one who, in whose hands all resources of the earth dance in whose hands. Meaning, the person is not clutching them. The person is a giver, is so big that everything belongs to such a person. This is what the whole thing. Ahoratre parshve. I command, as a person, you command the day and night. Day takes permission, you know. Day and night, day is on one side, night is on the other side. Day says, can I rise now? And the night says, is it my turn now? No, wait for 2 hours. Okay. This is how Krishna did that whole chavatkar with that sun, you know, eclipse and everything. This is what it's meant. That the days and the nights, they have to take permission before they rise and set. And then the stars are your embellishment. In fact, you are the star. When you start to star in the film of self-knowledge, you are the true star. You have to show up, you have to star in it, you have to know that I am the star. That is when you are the star. Nakshatrani Rupam. That's how the word came. You are the star. 5 star, 7 star, 27 star. Everything is you. Lone star. Anything you can take. You are the star. You are the starring. You have finally showed up in your own life. You are no longer that disconnected being. You are starring in your own life. And then what? You know? Yeah. The Bhagavan who heals. Ashwinis. You know? They are your mouth. Meaning what? Anything that you say is a word of blessing, is converted to a word of blessing, is converted to words of healing. You can never curse anything, anyone, anywhere, at any time. Whatever you say becomes true. You become Satya Sankalpa because you have everything. You don't need anything. Gaining the Purusha, you have gained everything. So you are not in competition with anything. That's why in the Mundaka Upanishad at the end it says, Atmagyam hi archayet bhutikamaha. Bhutikamaha means the one who wants bhuti, means things within samsara. Not vibhuti, bhuti. Bhuti means things within samsara. Good life, good house, good children, good grandchildren, good favors, good neighbors. All these things the one who wants. Please worship the person of knowledge, the one who has gained the Purusha. What is the connection? Because the one who has gained self-knowledge does not want anything, becomes a source of blessing for others. Ashvinau Vyaktam, this is what it is. Everything that comes is just like the Ashwini Devatas. They keep healing the whole universe. The person is a healer in the universe without even picking up one scalpel. The person is a healer. The person, he doesn't need to have the knowledge of herbs. The person's presence is a healing, blessing, benign presence. Whose presence? The person who is the Purusha. The person who has understood, I am the Purusha. And then what, you know? And then the people pray like this. The Devas are themselves praying, Ishtam Manishana, please give us all our boons. Sarvam Manishana, Amum Manishana. Amum means this thing, that thing. Yeah. Give me this thing, give me that thing. There is a clamor on part of people. Suddenly the person becomes so popular. The one who has vairagya, the one who has self-knowledge. Everybody approaches, Sarvam Manishana, give us everything. Please to give us here, give us, help us, give us. You become a blessing presence for the whole universe because you no longer need anything. You no longer want anything. And you have discovered the truth of yourself as totally content. Notice how we went from the Purusha to you. We ended in you. That is what Vedanta is. It's a big U-turn, pun intended. It all starts with you. it ends with you. You are in the beginning. You are at the end. You are in the middle. Nothing other than you. That is what the whole thing is. See, we have done it, we have finished it, correct? I kept my promise. We have done it line by line. Even though I said, you know, I had wanted a little elbow room, so I said, but we still did it more or less line by line. So I have been totally acquitted. And so this is good. We can, you know, close here. I want to thank all of you for coming. I want to thank Dr. Urmila, Dr. Premji, everybody to because and Srini and Savitri and all the people who have helped in organizing this. Wonderful. So thank you for inviting me. And then last year also when I came, I went back with such wonderful memories. This time also I'll take all wonderful memories of your eager faces, like the bees, you know. What is that? The bees of Advaita, you know, bees, you know, going towards the pollen of Advaita. That is how it is, the honey of Advaita, sipping the honey of Advaita. This is how I will remember you. So thank you very much. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. When the background is set, when the stage is set, it's not much to come and dance on it a little bit. This is what we did. We had a little dance with the Purusha Sukta. Any questions? Yeah. What is it? Tell me.
In the last one, what is spouse?
Huh?
Spouse.
Spouse.
What she said?
In the last one?
You mentioned spouse, the word spouse.
Spouse means wife or husband. Yeah. She was listening, huh? Yeah. Very good.
The past tense was spice.
Okay, I have a question on the spouse thing. In the last day, the Patna, the Krishna, the Shri, the Patna saying. So is it addressing the masculine part of it?
No, no. Feminine. Certain things are feminine. That's all it is. Forget all this masculine, feminine. Atma has no gender. No agenda, no gender.